Hello everybody. So today we're going to be doing this copper look with a red lip, perfect for a night out. So yeah, stay tuned and remember to click that subscribe button, which I need to remember to remind you guys. Let's continue. This is the GlossierCherryBalm.com. It's very moisturizing. It's tinted, which is fine. I just put a light amount. My bangs are in the way, as always. So I like to clip them back with some bobby pins. And move that hair away. And we will start. So first, is always primer. So this is the Dr. Brandt's Pores No More Luminizer Primer. And I just love Dr. Brandt products. So we should take a little bit of that. And I like to look glowy with this copper look. So I use the Becca Shimmering Skin Perfector Liquid. Just squeeze a little bit of that too. Mix it together with my fingers, warm up the product, and we'll just put it everywhere. Now that everything's primed, I have my Marc Jacobs Marvelous Mousse Foundation in the color 26 Bisque Medium. And I have my Japanesque 845 stipple brush. I think that's what it's called. I stipple it on first and then I blend it in. Trying to get those corners because I have some dark spots there. Now we move on to concealer. For my concealer, I have my Fit Me number 10 lights. Put some under my eyes. And the corners of my nose. And we'll go from there. What's left over on my eyelids. So now I'm going with my Wilder powder my base. My Wilder is from Glossier in light medium. And contour with the Guerlain Terracotta Bronzer, shade number 3, using this crown brush. Next with my tinted blush brush from Moda Pro, I'm gonna go back in and bronze. I'm actually gonna use two blushes. The first one is from Wet n Wild Pearlescent Pink blush, and I'm going to use my Besame Cosmetics blush brush. So with this color, I just like to use on the side of the cheeks. And next, we'll use my NARS in Orgasm. And that'll go on the apples of my cheeks. And now, highlights, the best part. So I'm using my Pixie by Petra in Peach Honey. Eyes. Sorry, couldn't remember what was gonna go next. So with this Nameless brush, we're gonna go all over the lid using my peach palette. We're gonna use white peach. We're going to do transition shade. Transition shade from the peach palette. And let's use Puree. So this one. Maybe I should zoom you in. I should be close enough. Just blend that out. No harsh lines are ever good. I like to use this as a base just to intensify the copper. So this is my NYX Golden Bronze. And we'll just put that on the eyelid. And blend it out. A finger. I don't even know if they have this brand anymore. I've had this too long. But this is the Naked Cosmetics Heavy Metal. And it's like a coppery bronze. Let me see if I can do this without spilling. With my finger, I'm just gonna press this onto my eyelid. And then blend it out. And the same on the other side. And with my blending brush, there we go. From Laura Mercier, we're gonna blend. Now, with this Marsk powder, it's a mineral eyeshadow in Your Toast. Just a tiny bit in the middle to kind of give like that halo effect. And same on the other side. I'm going to use the same brush because I'm lazy and don't want to look for a smaller brush. We're going to go back in with Puree. And we're just going to pinch it and go underneath. And a little bit of the copper as well. Going to use the Pixie highlight. So we're gonna go back and using that gold highlight. There we go. We're gonna put that in the inner corners. With my finger, of course. Now, with that same NYX, we're gonna put that in the waterline. I don't typically like putting stuff in my waterline, but with this look, I like it. Clean up with my broken Morphe brush, which I use for my powder. So, now we're going to attempt to do a winged liner. With my Tarte clay pot. This is my Essence of Beauty eyeliner brush that I've had for a million years. So yeah, angled. I've tried using those regular eyeliner brushes. They're just a straight point. I don't like them. So I just start off with a line on both sides. And I haven't done a winged liner in a very, very long time, especially with using a brush. Sorry about that, my camera just shut off on me. It said I was taking too long with my eyeliner and it got bored. So, almost done. Pretty good. Pretty good. We're going to curl them lashes. My lashes don't like to cooperate all the time, so I need to curl them. Sample size of the Dior Show Maximizer 3D Base Mascara Lash Primer. Really long name. I bought the Dior Show Mascara, and I'm like, oh, I'm gonna go back and buy the primer. Never did. Because I said, oh, I have all these sample sizes at home. So here you go. I am using my sample ones. I'm not really sure. I've seen people use the primer before mascara and then after mascara. Why? I don't know. But I just do it before mascara and I think it looks great when it's done. So I'm going to use my Dior Show in number 090, which I'm assuming it's the blackest black they have. But I love this mascara, even though the wand is a little too big for my tiny almond eyes. But I'll make it work. Just makes my lashes look so nice. Because I hate wearing fake eyelashes because they feel so heavy on my eyes. And I am going to put lipstick on, and my color that I'm going to be using tonight, because I love pairing this copper look with a red lipstick. So I'm going to be using the Pat McGrath. Beautiful packaging. In Elson, which if you haven't seen, You twist, the lips it comes straight out, it doesn't like turn. So then you go. But since this is a red lipstick, I like to use. And now I have red lipstick on my pants. Great. So yeah, I'm using my teeny tiny little lipstick brush, which is actually a Chanel lip liner, but I used up all of the lip liner, so I just crazy glued the top of the lip liner side to the brush, and now it's my little travel size. So I like to use that and get the corners first, because I have no lip liner. I don't typically use lip liners. That's just an extra thing to buy. So I use this. We'll go in with the lipstick. Lipstick is so smooth, so bright. It's like the perfect red lip. And when you take out this little lipstick bottle, it's so chic. That's what really like made me spend those $38 for lipstick. And now for the finishing touch, some Cover FX Illuminating Setting Spray. Yeah, shake that up. And a mist. Whoa, I got some in my eye. Gotta work on that YouTube setting spray look. And that is it. So, until next time, bye!